Welcome to Analytics with Nags. This is another video in the Visuals with Nags series in which we are going to discuss about Pareto chart, which is also called as 80-20 rule, where 80% of the effects occur from 20% of the causes. So we will try to identify 20% of the causes. Once we fix this, then 80% of the effects will be handled. So what is this, how we can implement it in Power BI? Let us check it out in this video. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. So Pareto chart, basically what or how it looks like, it's a kind of chart that contains bars and line graph. Basically it's a bar and line chart that is pre-existing chart in the Power BI, and we need to design it in such a way that your values should be represented in the descending orders by bars, and the cumulative total is represented by the lines. So once you have defined this chart and with this configuration, then it becomes a Pareto chart. And as we said, it is so famous for 80-20 rule, like 80% of the effects come from 20% of the causes. Meaning, like, if you consider some product testing, some defects or effects happening are causes 80% of the effects, right? That is due to only few causes. The main purpose of this chart is to identify this top 20% of the causes. Like over here, you can see in this chart where you can see 80% of the problem occurred due to these two tasks. So that covers almost maybe 10 or below 20%. So this is what it is, the Pareto principle is all about. And there are a lot of examples for a Pareto chart, a lot of applications for it. And in our case today, we are going to see about what is the total sales or which countries or which products have contributed 80%. It is not basically 80%, it is the key factor here. This part we need to identify. So these are the top countries that contributed more, almost 80%. Other countries are contributed only 20%. So it can be either used for negative case, like which are the two defects caused 80% of the effects, and it's not a two, which causes, right, top causes to identify the defects, and in a positive case, which are the countries contributed more sales, that is 80% of the sales. So this is the thing you need to understand. With this note, let us try to begin how to configure this in Power BI. We are in Power BI now, and I have designed this chart using different products. So in my case, I have given, like, this is my peak point, like these five products has almost contributed 80%, whereas other five products contributed only 20%. So I can focus on these five products now. So from this it is evident. And almost you can also see these two products alone contributed 50%. So viewing the data like this will give us very good understanding about what is happening. So now you can see I used the simple chart here, that is line and stacked column chart. Okay. So using that, I've created, either you can create this one also, line and clustered column chart, not an issue, whatever it can be. Now in order to do that, I will do step by step, and for that let us try to understand the data first. As I mentioned before, we need to have the data by different product wise, the descending. Let's try to view the data, and I have product name, and product name wise sales amount, that is the sales amount over here, right? and let us try to do it by descending. So I need to have the cumulative total first, right? So let us try to increase the data a little bit so that it is easy to understand for everyone. And I will make the background to gray so that it is easy for us to view it a little bit better. That's fine. Now I hope you can able to see it. Let me increase the size of the headers as well. Okay, now these are the products and this is my sales amount. I am viewing it by the descending of the sales amount. And once you have done that, you need to achieve the cumulative product, right? For that, I don't want to waste your time. I have already created the measure over here, that is Pareto cumulative. Now what it does is, let us try to walk through this code. You can take a screenshot and you need to write on your own for based on your different tables, right? So let me, instead of this product name, I will use the product name from the product master as it is already connected, right? So I connected here. Now let us go through this formula over here, that is Pareto cumulative. So what it does is, we need to get the total sales amount, and this sales amount should be greater than this sale, right? So each row it has to work on, and whether if it is greater than that value, till that it will loop through, then it will cumulate, right? That is the logic we have written it here. Once I put this one, you can see the value over here. Here I have divided, let me comment it out. I have divided the total sales here. Instead, I will try to get the cumulative value first, then we can see the percentage value. I need to remove this percentage. It should be whole number. There you go. Now you can see this summed up with the next value will give you 289150. And this summed up with this will give you 364750. So it is cumulative. At the end, you will get the desired results. So the core logic remains here. So the sale is sum of sales. We will store it in a variable. And then the calculate function does the magic as usual. We need to get the total sales. This sales measure is nothing but again the sum of sales, but I'm not using it from here, or either you can write it over here, sum of total sales, right? Sum of sales amount. Okay, so this calculates the sum of sales amount, and then filter all selected. So it will, I have already mentioned what all selected will do. So filter all selected the product master name. Here you use whatever value specific to your whatever reports you are using. Then use the calculate function. Calculate sum of sales. At the, here the context transition happens. Then it will try to compare with this variable. So it will loop through till the value is greater than that particular row, right? So once it matches, then it stops. So it will sum it up till this point. Then it will add the value. That is the logic you need to understand. So this is the formula. You can take a snapshot and you need to change accordingly. This product master is the value that you are using in the axis. Then this amount is the amount that you are trying to compare in a Pareto chart. That's it. Once you are done with this, then you are done with the cumulative value. And in order to get the percentage, we need to have the all sales, right? So all sales is available over here. The all sales is nothing but you need to divide this value, right? Parent of this value divided by all sales. That will give you some percentage, right? That is what I'm going to do it in the next step. So divide divide the entire thing, comma, sorry, after this, then that all cells, you put all cells here. This will give us some value in percentage, right? I need to set it to 2 digits and the decimal value, then you make it as a percentage. That's it. So the same formula, you are adding, you can create 2 separate measures and create another one, but I'm doing it in the same Pareto cumulative. So you can see here, this particular product itself will give you 25.75%. These two contributes to 50% and keeps on adding cumulative. So this is the logic we need to keep on. Once we are done, these are the 3 things we need. That's it. You can go and switch to your Pareto chart. Take this cumulative value over here. That's it. So we have already designed similar to what we have done so far. Let me take the formatting option from here and choose it over here. So I have set only the value for here. I mean, this will show you now from this diagram, as I mentioned before, these 5 products itself contributed 80%, and these 2 has contributed 50%. You can identify whichever is performing more in this case. So if you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.